MLB The Show's coverage of Major League Baseball is on the air. Should be a good one here this afternoon between the Miami Marlins and the New York Mets. Digging in now, Miguel Rojas. And we are ready for some daytime baseball.
The shortstop, Miguel Rojas.
Now here's the pitch. And a fastball is in there for strike one. One and one to the Marlins leadoff hitter.
Well, you always get a sense of the umpire's strike zone, usually early on in a game, and that's normally a pretty good clue. Second pitch of the game, and it's already looking like a tight zone.
Temperature about what you'd expect for this time of year, 56 degrees at first pitch. Oh, and a nice changeup that time gets him to swing right through it as the leadoff man is down on strikes to open up the ball game. First pitch coming, here it is. Jazz Chisholm comes on with one gone here as he looks at a called strike one. And that's inside off the plate with the fastball. It's one and one.
Pretty good pitch right there. Fastball in off the plate. One of the things you want to do as a pitcher, try to stand those hitters up.
Two and one the count. Here's the pitch. A great pitch there as he couldn't get extended on that one, and he's down on strikes for the second out.
Batting third.
Ready now for the Marlins. Starling Marte will attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. Two out, nobody on. Big swing and a miss at the fastball, and he's behind in the count 0-2.
Down 0-2. Maybe simplify the game plan right here. Get on the heater, even though he has five weapons to go to.
Working on striking out the side in the first.
I got to count 2-2.
Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Into the box now, Jeff McNeil. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
The second baseman, number six.
Now here's the pitch. So back-to-back sliders for strikes. Does he come back with yet another?
Hey, not normally a good plan to throw three consecutive sliders in a row. This guy's slider is so good, I think he might throw it again.
And that is Byam on into center field, so good hitting on 0-2 nets him a leadoff single.
Batting second, the center fielder.
Into the box now, Kevin Pillar. As he'll look at a fastball in there on the outer half, it's 0-1. Pillar, once a Toronto Blue Jay, he came here by way of trade earlier this year.
I know he'd tell you he'd like to be playing a little bit better, but I think it's as advertised for this ball club right now. I think the manager is getting exactly what they expected.
Line towards center field. Marte has to roam straight back, but he has it for the first out. So a runner at first with one out now. And up next, the left-handed hitting Michael Conforto.
Conforto.
From the stretch. Swinging a ball hit on the ground. And he won't even think about second as he'll flip on to first for the sure out. Coming to the plate now, Pete Alonso. And he could give his guys an early lead if he can come through here.
Alonso.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
That's out.
And they'll try and get him out in front to start the at bat, but this misses off the plate away. It's ball one. Checks his swing here, but he does so in time. Two balls and a strike.
He got two balls, one strike.
Outside part of the plate, the changeup is in there. He's set. The 2-2. High and deep down the left field line. And that will end up a foul ball. The 2-2 pitch. A swing and a miss as he chased with two strikes. And that will retire the side. Up next from Miami, Adam Duvall.
Leading off for the Marlins, the right fielder, number 14.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Well behind that fastball. It's a swinging strike. I had him reaching at thin air that time, and he's very quickly down 0-2.
Ugh, was that ugly. You could probably throw anything out there to this guy. He'd swing at the Raza bag if you throw it up there.
And they really bunch him up on that one as he swings and misses for the first out. The pitch. Jesus Aguilar stands in as he looks at a called strike. 1-1 now, the count to the Marlins' first baseman. And a curveball's by him that time as he falls behind now 1-2.
Wow, he's cruising right now out there. Four straight punch outs and working on number five.
And indeed, the throw will finish him off as they get the put out at first, and there are two away now. Coming to the plate now, Corey Dickerson. First two men in the inning have both gone down via the punch out, so we'll see if he can fare any better.
Nope.
Now a changeup here to start things out, but that'll dip a bit too low, and it's 1-0. Ball two now.
2-0.
Now the 2-0. Too high. And it's 3-0.
Now with the bases empty, I think he needs to be careful not to just groove one here just because it's 3-0. He's a guy that could ambush you and lose one over the wall.
So a runner at first with two away. And that'll bring up the outfielder, Brian Anderson. He's set and the pitch.
Oh, that pitch is up. Come on.
Anderson, originally from the Sooner State of Oklahoma. He was selected in the third round during the 2014 draft.
Yeah, Matty, they certainly got it right when they drafted this guy. He has turned himself into an...
Well, the left fielder's on it, and that retires the side. Last half of the second set to go. And coming forward now is the shortstop, Francisco Lindor. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Takes this the other way to right. But he will come on strong out there in right and pull this one down for the first out. Next for the Mets, James McCann. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Now here it comes.
Oh, that's just out.
The 1-0. Hit pretty well out toward right center field. Marte's after it. He gets there and makes a fine running play for the second out. So bases are empty here with two gone, and that'll bring up the left-handed bat of Dominic Smith. Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. This one is launched. Look at this. Gone into the upper tank. J.D. Davis the next at bat. And a swing from him yields a foul pop out of play to the right. He'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second. Hit hard on the ground towards second. Throw over to Aguilar at first. He'll take care of him to end the inning. Striding in, Jorge Alfaro. He'll step in to lead it off in the top of the third.
Jorge Alfaro.
Here comes the first pitch. Tried to golf at it, but he missed strike one.
Everything this guy throws is hard. That changeup he throws is in the high 80s to go along with that good heater.
Count now a ball and a strike. The 1-1. is swung on and missed, and that's strike
two.
One
ball, two strikes, count.
A shot down the first baseline. A dive, but it's off his glove. Throw to first in time, and the leadoff man is gone to start the third.
Batting nine.
Now to the plate, pitcher. The pitcher, Trevor Rogers, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Pulls the string on that one. One strike. Slow little grounder left side. On to first, and there were two down. Digging in, now Miguel back. Rojas. 0 for 1 here Miguel in the early going.
Rojas.
First pitch coming. Here it is.
Ball in.
Kind of a surprise not to see a fastball on the first pitch there. The guy's probably taking at least one pitch to give his pitcher a chance to sit down after he already made the second out.
2-0 now. 3-0 now. Jazz Chisholm would be next if they can keep this inning alive. 3-1 to the Marlins middle infielder. Hitters count all the way. Here it comes. Swing and a miss as he was way early on that one. 3-2.
Hey, there was great arm action on that 3-1 changeup right here. He's got this guy thinking. That's the beauty right now. We go to a full count.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. Bottom of the third now, and that'll bring up the pitcher, Jacob DeGrom.
The pitcher, Jacob DeGrom.
First pitch of the at-bat. Just a bit high with the fastball, but didn't get the call. Count even now at 1-1. One ball and two strikes to count. Lays off 2-2 now.
He got ahead with two good fastballs and then tried to drop the changeup to see if he'd be out in front. Did a great job of laying off that pitch right there. Interested to see where he goes now.
Ready with another 2-2.
Careful.
And he misses with it. Ball four. And a terrible start to the inning as he's walked the pitcher leading things off.
Number six.
Jeff McNeil will be the next to take a turn. Second at bat here. He reached via a single to lead off the home first. And a bit too high with that one. It's 1-0. Weak grounder back to the mound. There's one. But no real shot at two as he's safe easily at first. So one man gone for the Mets in the third. And that'll bring up a man who's a human highlight reel defensively, Kevin Pillar. He comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Hits this one hard the other way. And the hit and run works to perfection as it's into right for a base hit. And they'll have runners at the corners following the one out single.
The right fielder, number 30, Michael Conforto.
At the plate now, Michael Conforto. As the first pitch to him is in there for a called strike one. And 1-1 as this one's in on the hands. Throw over to the bag. Runner is back. Pulled high in the air out to right field. Catch is made here in right, and here comes the runner from third. And he is in there at the plate. It's now a 2-0 game. So it's a runner at first with two gone. And up steps the power bat of Pete Alonso.
Alonso.
From the stretch, here's the pitch. Alonso is a prolific power hitter, and you probably didn't need me to tell you that. Doesn't matter what kind of pitching he faces, there's a lot of pop in that bat. Outside, 3-0 now.
If I'm managing this hitter right here, he doesn't even have to look down at the third base coach. You know he's got the green light. He's one of the best hitters in your lineup.
Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. And a good at-bat that time as he lays off for ball four. And as a result, that'll move a runner up into scoring position now with two away.
Francisco Lindor.
First delivery to him on the way. Down the first baseline. This gets foul. It's 0-1. From the belt, the pitch. Fly ball out to straightaway right. Duvall is there, and he'll make the catch to retire the side. Now at the plate, Jazz Chisholm. He'll try to get it going here to begin the fourth.
The second baseman, Jazz.
First pitch of the at bat on its way. Swing and a chopper down the first baseline. But a foul ball here, 0-1. Now the pitch. Tries to bunt his way on here, but this is a foul ball. Looking to punch him out again, the pitch. And they'll try to tempt him with a curveball, but this bounces in front of the plate, and it's 1-2.
Hey, the fish ain't biting there on that 0-2 breaking ball, but you got to be careful because this pitcher might throw him another one.
Two balls and two strikes now. Oh, and this one's dangerously up and in as he hits the deck here. It's ball three now.
Hey, throwing the ball great up until this point. Don't want to allow a leadoff walk. Needs to just focus in on his mechanics right here.
He'll try it again, 3-2. Hit down the line at first, but this will get foul, so they'll do it again, 3-2. A payoff pitch one more time. Turned on down the line, and this is going to be a foul ball.
I know the fans love the souvenirs, but the battle between the pitcher and batter right here is what makes the game great.
Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. And he'll finally just wear him down as this one swung on and missed for the first out.
The center fielder, number
six. Digging in next will be Starling Marte. 0-for-1 for him here in this one. And he lays off a pitch in there for the first strike.
Man, this guy's been incredibly efficient so far in this one, mostly because he's getting ahead. 70% of the batters he's faced, he's thrown a first pitch strike to.
Hit out towards second. And that's the second out. Digging in, Adam Duvall comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
At the ball. Ball one, no strike.
Dangerous curveball that time, but laid off as it drops into the top of the zone.
Great pitch right there. That is a huge breaking ball. Not shocked he took it. Got to calibrate that one for a second.
Lays off the changeup, and he's ahead in the count now, 3-1.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
And that one's taken outside for a ball. He walked him. So no 1-2-3 inning here. They've got themselves a two-out base runner.
Aguilar.
First pitch coming. Here it is. Jesus Aguilar is in for his second plate appearance as he looks at a ball. It's 1-0. Changeup stays outside and he's behind 2-0. Down low, and the plot thickens here, 3-0. From the belt, kicks and deals. And he misses again, ball four. And that's back-to-back guys now that have reached base via the base on ball.
Corey Dickerson.
Here comes the first pitch. Corey Dickerson is at the plate as he takes a cold strike one. Trying to hang a zero, here's the pitch.
One ball.
He's already walked two in this inning already. This guy just can't seem to find the strike zone.
In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. Breaking ball misses the corner. Two balls and two strikes.
Good job to lay off that 1-2 breaking ball. Put himself right back in this at bat.
2-2 pitch is fouled away. Has a look, now the pitch. He pulls this one into right, and he'll get there in plenty of time to put this one away, and that ends the inning. Digging in to try it again, James McCann. He flew out in his last at bat.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
0-1 the count. Here's the pitch. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. After it is Marte. He gets there and makes the play for the first out. So one away here with the bases empty. And that'll bring up the left-handed bat of Dominic Smith.
The last at bat, Matty V, we heard this guy's a good fastball hitter. He got a fastball and didn't miss it. We'll see if they pitch him a little bit differently this time and mix in some off-speed pitches.
Fly ball right down the line and left. And this will wind up a foul ball. The windup and the 0-2 pitch. And the slider gets him swinging, two gone. Next up from New York, J.D. Davis. He's 0-for-1 after grounding out in his only trip to the plate so far. First offering on its way.
Nope.
Two runs, three hits, and no errors on the Mets line score so far. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone.
Hey, always a good idea to take a couple of pitches when you're facing a young arm like this one. And now he's put himself in a real good hitter's count.
Now the 2-1 pitch. Popped him up. Alfaro moving to his left. And the inning is over. Now at the plate, Brian Anderson. He's in to get things going here in inning number five.
We're moving through the middle of this ball game right now. If they want to get things going, how about trying to get some base runners on or at least get a base hit? They don't have any hits going into this part of the game.
He got a swing and a miss on that last pitch, but that's not the location he wants to live in against a hitter of this quality.
Here comes the nothing and two pitch.
One ball.
Well, there's the classic 0-2 wasted fastball. Not even close to the zone. We'll see what he throws on the next pitch.
And 2-2.
That was a nasty sweeping slider right there. If he was able to just catch the back door a little bit, he would have picked up that backwards K.
Swing and a miss on the slider, and that's out number one.
Now batting, catcher, Jorge Alfaro.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Jorge Alfaro is at the plate here as he quickly finds himself down a strike. It's 0-1. Good changeup, and it's 0-2.
Man, this guy's really pitched well so far, attacking the strike zone, and he's really kept these hitters off balance.
Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2. Count even at 2-2 to the Marlins catcher.
He went with the off-speed there once he got him to 0-2, but now that they both missed, I think we'll see more of a challenge pitch here. You don't have to give in, but you can't be too cute either.
Fouled away. The 2-2 one more time.
We got a full count.
It's a fine line from working down in the zone on 2-2 and bouncing one in there that basically stands no chance at getting swung at. right there, he basically spiked that one right into the dirt, and now he has to find the zone on a 3-2 pitch.
Got him swinging on the fastball there. Jorge Alfaro becomes the second out here in inning number 5. And this one's nowhere close as that bounces to the plate for ball one. And he won't bite at that one either. It's 2-0.
Can't fall behind against a pitcher. Need to minimize pitch count against the easy outs, and this is certainly one of them.
2-1 now. Now here's the pitch.
One thing that could nag at you as a pitcher is having to work really hard to get a guy that you think you should be able to cruise right through. He's not known for his offensive prowess, but he's putting together a real nice at bat here.
And he lays off here. It's ball four, and that is really cause for concern as he's just walked the opposing pitcher.
Miguel Rojas
has a look. Now the pitch. Miguel Rojas is at the plate now, and he takes a cold strike. Swing and a liner, but foul. And a check swing. Did he go around? No, says the first base umpire. It's ball one. Here's the 1-2 delivery. No offer at the curve that time, and it's knotted up at 2-2. To third. Oh, and he can't pick it up cleanly. Digging in once again, Jazz Chisholm. And we'll see what he can do here with a pair of runners on base and two gone here in the fifth. Looking to wiggle out of this. Here it is. And a changeup here, but that's taken low in the dirt for a ball. Swing and a miss out in front of a changeup. Fouled off. And it's fouled away. The 1-2 is swung on and missed, strike three. So here now is the pitcher, Jacob DeGrom. He drew a walk his first time up.
The pitcher, Jacob.
Pitch on the way. Hit on the ground out to short. Scooped up. Throw to first is in time for the first out. So here's Jeff McNeil. He's 1-for-2 in this one. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Grounded up the first baseline. Reined in. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. So bases are empty here with two gone. And that'll bring up a man who's a human highlight reel defensively, Kevin Pillar. To short. He's got it. On to first, and can you believe it? A three-pitch inning, and just like that, the side is retired. Here's Starling Marte. No hits to this point.
Leading off for Miami, the center fielder, number 6.
Starling. Here comes the first pitch.
Marte.
Oh, and that one slung through the strike zone that time at 98. 0-1. Fastball called for strike two.
Your idea of working the count goes out the window. You're frustrated right now. Down 0-2. Got to find a way to grind.
And he reaches out for one and may have chased it as this is skied into the air to straightaway center. Pillar is there, and he has it for the first out. So here's the cleanup hitter, Adam Duvall. It was a walk in his last trip. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch.
Nope, that's down.
It's really hard to work deep in the games when you're having an outing like this guy is. You're going to strike out a lot of guys. Well, guess what? Your pitch count's going to go up, too.
No runs, no hits, and no errors in the game for the Marlins. And he fouls this one off. Yanked on the ground down the line. But this is a foul ball as the count holds steady at 1-2. Misses ball two.
Well, I think that pitch is the result of a lot of foul balls. He might have tried to do a little bit too much with it, trying to get him to swing through it, but it just ended up taking off on him.
Full count, 3-2. Neither guy willing to give in, and the at-bat will continue. Popped him up. McCann is right there. And that's out number two. Digging in, Jesus Aguilar. It was a walk in his last trip.
Aguilar.
First offering on its way. Pulled the fastball down a little too much there. That's ball one. And he falls behind now, 2-0.
Man, this guy's had their number all game long. Up, down, in and out. He's pitching very well.
3-0 now.
Yeah, he's all over the place right now. No doubt he's clearly fighting his mechanics.
And this is taken low for ball four, and they'll have themselves a two-out base runner here after all.
Up next for the Marlins.
Now at the plate, Corey Dickerson. He's 0-1 thus far. First pitch of the at-bat. Tying run at the plate, the 0-1. Not a bad pitch there with two strikes, but it misses 1-2.
Man, the pitcher let the guy off easy right there. That 0-2 pitch wasn't even close. I'd rate that as a non-competitive pitch.
The 1-2.
Ball two. 2-2 to count.
Well, this has been a good at-bat. He's now worked a count full to 3-2. It allows the runner on first to be on the move with two away.
And he struck him out. So it might be time to begin the countdown as he's now gone through six innings without allowing a base hit. Bottom of the sixth inning now. And digging in is the outfielder, Michael Conforto.
The right fielder, Michael Conforto.
Outfield shaded toward right center. Here's the first pitch. The 1-0 is offered at and missed for the first strike. Conforto behind, a ball and two strikes. The 1-2. Well, he's having a good amount of success here, Dan, even though he hasn't really gotten a ton of swings and misses.
Yeah, but for him, Matt, he's more of a pitch-to-contact kind of guy, and obviously it's working so far, and the way he pitches, it really keeps his pitch count down.
Throw on to first in time, one away.
Now batting.
And next will be the Mets cleanup hitter, Pete Alonso. It was a walk in his last trip. Infield in the overshift here, now the pitch. He'll hold off on the slider to start the at-bat. It's ball one.
Man, that's one of those. How could you not swing at that one? A good take there on that pitch.
And he gets this one over at the knees for the first strike.
Nasty 2-0 slider right there for a strike. No shame in tipping your hat.
Down the first baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Sent on the ground, but right into the shift. And there's out number two. Ready once again, Francisco Lindor. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Matty, he checks every box. Charisma, smile, hits from both sides of the plate with pop, defense, you name it. GM's dream right here.
Maybe trying to back him up a bit there with the fastball.
That's a good job right there. You very rarely see pitchers double up where they go a pitch inside. Normally, they'll go back outside, but he followed that up with another pitch on the inside part of the plate.
Slow roller, left side. Throw over to Aguilar at first. He'll take care of him to end the inning. Dylan Betances is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 68. Dylan.
Now to the plate, Brian Anderson. 0 for 2 on his line thus far.
We're moving right along into this one as we head into the late innings. Listen, if you want to score, you got to have to bunch some hits together, and they haven't been able to do that so far. So hopefully this leadoff guy, this will be the right guy at the right spot to get something going.
Here's the 0-1.
0-1.
Swung on and missed. 1-2 now.
This offense has been underachieving all day, putting way too much pressure on their own pitching staff. Someone has to have a quality AB and get this line going.
And he'll lay off the curveball that's in the dirt that time, and it's back to even now at 2-2. Oh, a fastball swung on and missed, and for the second time today, he's gone on strikes.
Now batting.
Stepping up to the plate, Jorge Alfaro. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and kind of shocked he got blown away with a fastball. You can tell he was late on that one. And we'll see if he tries to cheat to something this AB.
The 1-0 home. One out, nobody on. Hit hard on the ground to third. Throw gets him, two down. Garrett Cooper will grab a bat and hit for the pitcher here.
Number 26, Garrett Cooper.
Good fastball down around the knees there, taken for a strike. Here's a late swing and a miss, strike two.
One pitch away from wrapping up a very good inning's work out of the bullpen here.
Pulled the fastball down a little too much there. That's ball one. Scorched to third. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired.
Please join for the traditional seventh inning stretch.
John Curtis gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh.
Number 39.
Bottom of the inning now. And next to hit is the catcher, James McCann.
Leading up.
First pitch on its way.
McCann.
Counts 1-0.
If you've been paying attention, the guy on the mound does not want to come inside. If I'm at the plate, I'm leaning out over.
High in the air out towards shallow right. Duvall has to come in a few steps, but he has it for out number one.
Now
sliding into the box, Dominic Smith, 1-for-2 in the ball game thus far. Ready to deliver, here's the first pitch. Line drive, base hit. Around first, digging for two. And he is in at second base with a one-out double.
Now batting, the third baseman, J.D. Davis.
To the plate now, J.D. Davis, as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. 0-for-2 for him to this point. A little quick on that swing, and he finds himself behind 0-2. Hoping to send him packing, pitch on its way. Tries the slider to ring him up, but he lays off 1-2. Fouled away. Smith leads off second with one gone in the inning. Count still at 1-2. From the belt, the pitch.
Ball. 2-2 count. 3-2.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Liner towards second. And that's through into right field for a base hit. And they won't risk it at third, so they're at the corners now with only one away. Brandon Nimmo will look to provide a little punch off the bench as he'll hit with runners at the corners and one out in the inning. Outside target here, and he hits it for strike one. And it's quickly 0-2. Nothing in two count, and the pitch.
One ball.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
And this ball is crushed deep down the right field line. And nearly a three-run shot. Instead, it's a foul ball. Another 1-2 delivery.
Gotta believe the pitcher and catcher understand the fact that he's covering away, and he's covering way away. Don't be shocked if he comes in with something.
High in the air down the right field line. But this is just going to wind up being a foul ball. Still 1-2 as he fouls it away. Runners are at first and third, one away. Hit down the line at first. To second for one. Relay to Aguilar. The double play, and that retires the side. Trevor May has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 65. Trevor.
Ready to begin the eighth, and stepping in is the veteran shortstop, Miguel Rojas.
Starting to run out of time. They haven't been able to score any runs as we're moving late into this one. A perfect time for this leadoff guy to try to get on base and ignite a rally.
A one pitch on its way. Now a ball lined to the left side. But this will be a foul ball. A pause and the 0-2. Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out. Stepping in, Jazz Chisholm. He's hitless in three at-bats to this point. Here comes the first pitch. Starts him with a good rising fastball there for strike one.
Big fastball is definitely this guy's M.O. coming out of the bullpen.
A swinging strike, and now it's 0-2.
He knows full well he's sitting on a hat trick right here. All he's trying to do is avoid the golden sombrero.
Count remains at 0-2. Lifted down the line and left. And this will wind up a foul ball. Off the outside that time as the breaking ball can't catch the zone. Inside with the slider, and that'll back him up a bit. Here now the 2-2.
We got three balls.
Not sure if that was a purpose pitch or not, but I liked it. As a pitcher, sometimes you've got to be willing to back the guy off a plate by running something hard inside. You can't just let guys be comfortable standing in the batter's box against you.
You froze him on the fastball there. Jazz Chisholm takes his fourth strikeout of the game. From the stretch. The 0-1 on its way. Ground ball sent back up the middle. Fielded cleanly. And the off-balance throw will be too late. So a good effort that time, but it's an infield single.
The right fielder.
Stepping in now, Adam Duvall. As the first pitch misses to him, it's ball one. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Marte off for second. Strike called. Now the throw down. It's wide, and he's in there with the stolen base. This is line to left. And the stolen base winds up as a moot point as the inning is over. Richard Blyer is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 35.
Now back to the top of the Mets order, digging in, Jeff McNeil. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Leading up for the Mets, the second baseman, number 10.
Here's the first pitch to him. And he takes ball one. Hammers it to deep right field. A ball that's carrying. Oh, and a great diving catch for the first down. Ready for another chance? Kevin Pillar. He got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Hit on the ground down the first baseline. And that's a fair ball as it's through into right field.
The right fielder, number 30, Michael.
Into the box, Michael Conforto, as it's grounded sharply to first. One there, on to first as they get the double play to get him out of the inning. Edwin Diaz takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door.
Number 39, Edwin.
Stepping into the box, Jesus Aguilar. Head-to-head against Edwin Diaz. He's 1-for-4.
Leading off for the Marlins, the first baseman.
Here comes the first pitch. Hit hard to short. Oh, what a stop on the slide. Got him. So striding forward now, Corey Dickerson. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system, especially now he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
It's becoming more and more common in today's game to see relievers like this that can run it up there close to 100 miles per hour. But it's so fun to watch it. He blew it right by him there.
And Dickerson behind 0-2 now. The 0-2 pitch. There's a fastball well off the plate for a ball. And they're working the outer half here, but that one's wide for ball three.
Boy, went from being in the driver's seat to now being in some trouble. Had the count 0-2, started nipping at the corners, and next thing you know, this count stands at 3-2.
He froze him on the breaking ball that time. Corey Dickerson is retired, and now they're down to their final out in this one. First pitch of the at-bat. Brian Anderson is at the plate now as he looks at strike one. Oh, and one, here it comes.
Outside, that's the ball.
Count is 1-2 now. A crowd of over 39,000 on their feet. Inside and a hair low. It's 2 balls and 2 strikes. Miami down to their last strike. And he gets strike three called to end it here. And with that, this one is over.
Well, as a former pitcher, you know I love these low-scoring games as opposed to those slugfests. This was like a throwback game when home runs weren't so common and pitching was really dominant. No complaints here.
A 2-0 finish today. The New York Mets took the lead in the second inning and rode that until the very end. Jacob DeGrom is the winning pitcher of record. Trevor Rogers pitched well, allowing only 2 earned, but ends up taking the loss. So that just about does it for Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, Heidi Watney, and our entire crew. I'm Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, make your way over to theshownation.com.
the final line score for this afternoon's ball game. For the victorious New York Mets, 2 runs, 6 hits, 1 error, they left 6 men on base.